Hi. I decided I want to make myself a new purse, bag, whatever, carry thing. Because it's going to be bigger than what I would really consider a purse. So I might make a smaller carry hand thing. Anyway. So I have not even begun the process. I know how big I want it to be, and I know that I want the cover to be crazy quilt style. And that's it. So I thought, why not share the process? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna share the process of figuring out what fabric I'm gonna use, figuring out how to cut it. I don't have a pattern. I just have rough dimensions in my head and a basic idea of what kind of materials I want to use and in what way. But that's it. I don't really have any other plan. So you can watch this unfold. This is not a tutorial. This is not a how to make your own bag. Unless you're crazy. I shouldn't say that. Unless you're eccentric enough. No? I'll get back to you on... I don't know. If you just want to do it the way I do it, I guess this could be a tutorial, but I don't intend to actually give you advice on, or even a lesson on, how to do what I'm doing. It's just going to be observation. Okay, here we go. Gonna have to start in here, the closet of fabric, because I think I want to use old pants for the foundation. I don't know that I want jeans. I have some... Ooh, here we go. This might be good because these have lots of, like, pockets I could reuse. But see, these poor things, they just got patched and patched and repatched until finally I was like, okay, can't wear them anymore. Yeah, it's a sad thing. So this will be my foundation, this pair of pants. I might even be able to get this strap out of that. In fact, I'm sure I can. So there's the pants. And then because this is going to be a purse and I don't intend to make it something I can put in the wash, that opens up a world of possibility for fabric for the cover. But I think I want to stick with using up some scrap, so need to go to these. Yeah. Still unsorted, and I'm trying to remember if I have bags of scrap somewhere else. I don't remember. Okay, so. I think what I want to do is set the camera down somewhere so I can use both hands. So. Figure out where the best place is to do. Okay, so I'm speeding this up. I'm just gonna pick out scraps and make a pile and then come back and show you the pile. It's nothing overly special. Yeah, that's all that's happening. I'll probably speed up another part of the video too, so you get to see the crazy woman in fast mode. Pants that will be the foundation, and then just a variety of random scraps that I like. I'm not trying to make it color coordinate or... Yeah, there's no theme other than fabrics I like. So, I'm gonna set the camera up a different way and see what I can figure out about cutting out the base of the bag. Alright, so I've already done the ironing. Hey, the batteries died on the camera, so I got them recharged. So I've done the ironing and sorting of the scraps. So you're basically gonna get to watch me figure it out. So I'll show you the pieces I have so far. So for the base, these are the two sides, right? I'm gonna do those last because I'll probably have little scraps and I can use the scraps. And then this is either the front or the back. And this is the one that isn't. I've cut them in such a way that one will be longer to be the bottom and the other one will be longer at the top to flap over. But I'm using the hem from the pant leg to be the bottom. So when I start the crazy work, I'm gonna try starting it up at that hemmed edge. I'm working my way down it. That way there's already a nice finished edge at the top of both of those pieces. And I don't have to hem it or do anything to it. That's my plan. It might change. I think I need a different needle and different thread in my machine. So, anyways, I'm gonna get tucked in, as they say.
Because we really need to know the name of this man that she was seeing. Hazel?
Since I'm using a lot of thick fabrics, I put a jeans needle in there. So, speeding it up again. Gonna save you from all that tedium, because it was tedious. So, fast motion of just stitching along. I'm listening to a show, and so you don't have to listen to that. But then, of course, there's no music or anything for the whole time that this is going. Lickety split. And it was nice of me to like try to show you what I was doing as I went, wasn't it? Eventually I'm going to get a camera angle figured out that works, that I can use more consistently. But of course I had my snack, I had my drink, to keep getting up, getting new fabric. It was fun. Watching my show while I'm doing it, you know, the whole thing. It was a good time. So, keep watching and you'll see what else happens. and see what I'm seeing. So this is the top. See, there's the hem of the pants. I fold it over on this side, that fabric there. This is a denim that has like a velvet flocking or something on it. This is actually a very sheer fabric. This is velvet. So, this is the first piece. I have another one the same size to do, and then the two side pieces. I've done it with such large pieces of fabric because I'm thinking I'm going to end up embellishing this quite a bit. And if I use large pieces, then I'll still be able to see the fabrics that I like behind the embellishments. So, I'll figure out how I want to do the camera for the next part and see you in a bit. Here, I tried the camera angle off to the side. I don't like it any better than I liked the other way. Actually, I think I like it less. So, speeding up most of that. And whenever the video comes back, I apologize now because I, some reason, I just had no clue how loud it was going to be, or didn't think about the fact that the camera is actually closer to the computer, which is what's making the music. So the music is going to be really loud for the rest of, well, for the part after this. It's very loud, so be ready for that. I think I skipped parts where I was explaining how my machine has all these cool stitches there. Okay, so this is the top, and this is going to be the part of it where there'll be a flap that comes over and attaches here, theoretically. I mean, obviously I don't know that. And then down here I made marks. Can you see that? So you will know, so I'll know when I'm stitching it, where the bottom is. See? So then the bottom is this part. Alrighty, just gonna keep going. Let's see, what do we want to do next? It's a curve, though. Curve. Crummy. I'm gonna make it work. I'm just gonna make it work. So when I stitch it down, I always go back to my straight stitch in the middle. And then let's see if I can stitch this curve with any degree of accuracy. Maybe I can. See how it looks. Hey, that's not bad. That's not bad. So, I'm going to pick out a stitch. Anything will show up on this because it's a solid color. Which I find fabulous. So, how about it's funny, I have two tables. Really, they're not even tables, they're nice big desks, library desks. Two of them. And this little TV tray thing is really my favorite thing to use for my sewing machine. It's kind of wobbly, but I have all this open on both sides. I don't know why, but I really, this feels better to me than when I have it sturdy table. So, we'll
What do you do? Okay, here we go. I'm gonna give you a little bit of a... You can see what's going on here. Not the foot you're supposed to use for embroidery stitches. That foot broke and I haven't replaced it yet. But the machine lets me use this one, so I'm doing it. Because not using the embroidery stitches is not an option. Okay, I'm gonna put it someplace new now. Okay, we'll see how this goes. The light's probably not any better. Let's see if I can zoom it in. Maybe that'll help. Because I hung the camera up on the door by the camera strap, and it's very light and pretty behind me, but I can't see my face, at least I don't think so. Anyway, it doesn't matter, and you can't see this at all. I'll just hold it up. I was wrong, it's a solid color, but it's a fuzzy fabric, so the stitches are almost invisible. Almost, not there. You'll see what I mean. Can't see it. Oh, there, look at that. Alrighty, I got carried away and did all of the construction off camera. So I'm sorry about that. So I took a big strip from the pants and did a bunch of crazy quilting on it, and then I folded the edges in and covered up the raw edges with the ribbon. Had a little bit of this ladybug left and some of this satin red and green stuff. So the main construction is complete now on my little bag, purse, whatever you want to call it. It doesn't have a lining, it doesn't have any pockets. Got the sides and the bottom, and let's see if I can do one where I put it on and you can see. Oh gosh, where am I gonna put this? Strap because I wanted it to be at a specific place on my body whenever I did this. I don't want it like up here. I want it where I can stick my hand in like this and grab whatever it is I want to grab. So you can only see the strap. Well, I'll back up. So this is the purse. Here's the flap. There's the bottom. One side, and the other side, and the back. It's all crazy like I wanted it. I really am very pleased with this. I need to make a lining, and I'm going to take the pockets from the pants. There's that kind, and then there's this kind that has like a little snap closure. I just cut them right out of the pants, I'm going to put those on the lining, or in the lining, so that there are pockets inside the purse. So there'll be a big one like this and two like this. But I'm probably going to use the purse before I even do that. But I like having pockets, so I will do it. But this is as far as I'm going to get today. Maybe I'll do another video when I make the lining. Maybe not. I don't know. But this is my crazy quilt purse. Pre-embellishment, pre-lining. It'll be a work in progress, as most of my favorite things are. So, oh, there you go. If you have any questions, put them in the comments. Thanks.